Now, does your employer let you accumulate unused sick and vacation days for years and years and then write you a big fat check when you decide to leave? Didn't think so.
But a little digging by ABC 27 found that the state is a pretty generous employer when it comes to departing workers. And while it looks for every penny to cobble together a budget, millions and millions of dollars are literally walking out the door. Page after page, payout after payout. An ABC 27 right to know request found that in the past 2 years alone, the House and Senate have doled out well over $3 million each in unused sick and unused vacation pay to departing employees. 20 walked out the door with more than 30 grand, 11 got more than 40,000, and 9 top 50 grand. A dozen got $60,000 or more. Watchdogs are barking.
You shouldn't be able to use sick days as a financial investment vehicle. It shouldn't be a golden parachute. You know, we've reached the point of no return.
But the payouts are policy and legal, and there's bipartisan participation. Randy Albright left the Senate Democrats to become Governor Wolf's budget secretary. He said he used just 2 sick days in 29 years, and though he hasn't technically left the building, Albright was rewarded with more than $115,000 in unused sick and vacation when he left the Senate.
I do think it's important to, you know, sit here and speak to you directly. I'm not going to hide from what the facts are and the compensation that I did receive.
Albright wouldn't talk about the appropriateness of the payout policy. But the guy whose job it is to balance the state's books insists that if you want good employees, you have to offer them a good deal.
The compensation levels need to be appropriate to attract that caliber staff.
The Senate's former chief clerk, Russ Faber, got a going away of more than $104,000. The chair of the PUC, Gladys Brown, left Senate Democrats with nearly $79,000. And Christian Callahan, chief of staff to House Majority Leader Mike Terzai, left for a lobbying job with 62 grand in unused sick and vacation. The fiscal watchdogs are also barking.
I think this is why people that aren't in government, or at least in politics, get frustrated with the system, because
Eugene DePasquale is a former lawmaker and the state's auditor general.
Clearly there's no cap on it, there's no control on it, and very few of any people in the private sector have anything remotely close to that. And so when you're especially dealing with these tough budget times that the state is facing, reforms have to be put in place to tackle this.
Policy here needs change too.
Current lawmakers also want reforms.
It rattles my chain quite a bit. Obviously, that's something, now that this has been brought to light, something we got to look into.
The Senate boss says don't just look at the legislature. The problem is Commonwealth-wide.
Well, let me tell you, Dennis, there's some egregious things going on even outside of that.
Indeed, a longtime worker under the governor's jurisdiction recently boasted on Facebook about accumulating sick days years ago when he made $10 an hour and cashing them out at his current $55 an hour. Again, it's policy. And what exactly is the incentive for the policy protectors to change it before it's their turn to cash out?
At the Capitol, the most important term is OPM, other people's money. And when you're spending other people's money, you tend to be much more generous than you would if it were your own money.
And again, we should point out, these are not pensions we're talking about. These are unused sick and vacation. They get pensions on top of that. We should also note that in 2010, much to the chagrin of many employees I've talked to, House Democrats did put caps on how many sick and vacation days their workers could accrue and then cash out.